Radical abolitionist John Brown, depicted in this mural at the Kansas State House, spent time in Topeka 160 years ago this week. He then took part in what became known as the Battle of the Spurs on January 31st, 1859, in what is now Jackson County. This is Tim Rencher, the history guy for CJ Online, talking about Brown, who was born in 1800 in Connecticut. Brown ran various businesses before moving in 1855 to Kansas, where he led opponents of slavery the following year in battles with pro-slavery forces that caused the territory to become known as Bleeding Kansas. Brown became known for his fearlessness and willingness to kill people. Brown, shown here in an image provided by the Kansas State Historical Society, was a wanted man by December 1858, when he and his followers liberated 11 slaves in western Missouri. One of those gave birth to a child soon afterward. The slaves were brought to Topeka, where the group stopped at the home of John and Mary Jane Ritchie, shown here. The group then continued north until a federal posse of slavery supporters blocked its way near what is now Netowaka. Both sides sent for reinforcements. Help for Brown arrived first from Topeka. On January 31st, 1859, Brown and his supporters, despite still being outnumbered 2-1, crossed a creek and charged the posse on horseback. The posse fled with no shots being fired. The incident became mockingly known as the Battle of the Spurs. The slaves were then taken north to freedom. But in October 1859, Brown led a raid on the federal armory of what is now Harper's Ferry, West Virginia, hoping to start a slave revolt. But he and his men were defeated, and Brown was hanged for treason on December 2nd, 1859. This is Tim Rencher, the history guy, for CJ Online.